Hello guys, welcome back to Custom Gamer. My name is Daz, and this is the show where we talk about level design while playing cool maps, as always. Today we're having a look at the new and updated version of Station 51 by Sam Coombs. The original was released on the 22nd of May last year, so it's been almost exactly a year between the original and this update. This update contains changes to the first original map, a couple of layout changes, some minor things, some combat changes, and this entirely new second map, of course, which is what we're going to look at today. It carries on directly after the first map, so you grab the airboat at the end of the first level, and then you come out into this canal here. The reason I don't have the airboat in this video is just because I started the episode from the second map. I didn't play the first one through first on this video recording. So normally you'd have an airboat here, but you kind of get stuck here pretty much instantly with it, which is a bit of a shame. I was kind of expecting to be able to go through the canals and stop off at various locations with it, but no, you basically have to dump it straight away. This whole level is kind of interesting because it's very, very open. It feels like from every single area you enter, you can see most of the other areas from it, which is probably an optimization nightmare. I was reading a blog which Samuel wrote after finishing this map, kind of a breakdown of the map, how it went, problems along the way, things like that. It's a really good read. It's on his ModDB page. I'll link it in the description below this video. It's kind of a post-mortem of the map, basically. And he did mention that optimization was a bit of a pain here because there's so much visibility into other areas from just about every part of the level. It is kind of nice though, because you can see, you can look through windows and portholes and, you know, destroyed grates and things like that all over the place and see other parts of the level. So you can kind of see where you're going to go later on. Unfortunately, it does mean that he had to cut back on detail in a lot of these areas to get the map within his performance margins. Some of the areas do look quite boxy, unfortunately. There's a lot of places where a little bit of extra detail wouldn't have gone amiss. It's something that did bug me a bit about most of the level, actually. It just felt like another detail pass could have been greatly appreciated. But again, I think it just comes back to the, again, like I was talking about, the amount of visibility in the level. You can just see so much from all over the place, it's very hard to get your portals and, you know, this blocking everything to actually do decent work when it's open like this. Now, while I really enjoyed the combat scenarios in this map, it's definitely a lot harder than a lot of maps. Which isn't really a problem in itself, you just have to be ready for it. This level did start kicking my ass at the beginning, the first time I played through it. I just had to kind of adapt. Because normally I tend to just Rambo Half-Life 2 maps, because I've been playing the game for so long, I generally just kind of know how it works. But yeah, I had to be a little bit more careful here. Got some sniping going down. Yeah, one thing I wasn't particularly fond of was just once you get past that initial area in the canal, it's basically all combat from now onwards. I mean, he does try and vary up the combat quite a lot, so you fight Combine, and then you'll fight some zombies, and then you'll fight kind of Combine mixed with zombies. You know, there's a gunship in one part as well, so it's very, very varied, but I don't think there's enough of a gap between kind of large combat segments, so it just feels like it all just clumps into one just huge combat throughout the entire rest of the level. There's no real puzzles to solve. There's a little bit of kind of navigation, just kind of working out the route to go forwards. Like, for instance, here's a good example. You kind of have to climb over this destroyed building. But even while you're doing that, you're fighting enemies. Kind of, there's some sniping segments along there as well. You're trying to clear out enemies while you're doing the navigation puzzle. But yeah, I just feel like it could have used some sections have some kind of story sections or something. One thing that was kind of nice as well in this map is that there's like hidden crates absolutely all over the place. That's something I really like in maps, although I think perhaps here maybe there's perhaps too many. You kind of ended up getting like crate apathy. But it's just that finding a crate is no longer like, you know, it should be an exciting moment like, hey, I found a little secret area or found a little reward for exploring around here. In Station 51 Part 2, they're just absolutely everywhere. Here's a great vista that Sambri uses over and over again throughout the level. Just looking onto the Combine base structure in the distance there. This is actually something I want to talk about a bit, because it's really cool to see some kind of different looking Combine architecture. I mean, Sam uses the Combine textures, obviously, but the architectural style is just very, very different from anything I've seen before in either Half-Life 2 or any custom maps. I think it's because most mappers kind of just use you know, some basic kind of brushwork and then just kind of add the Combine props on top of it to give it that kind of Combine look with all the like the wall panels and fences and everything. Sam doesn't really do that too much here. It's kind of very, very much more a brush-based approach. So while the structures end up looking a little bit less detailed as a result, they're certainly a lot more unique, which I kind of like. I mean, maybe Sam could have used a few more props to kind of hide the silhouettes of the structures a little bit more, but I do like it a lot. It's always nice to see some unique architecture in Half-Life 2, especially when it's something of a familiar theme like the Combine. This area gave me some real trouble on my first time through the map. So you can actually shoot through the grate in the bridge there above me, and the Combine can shoot down through it as well. But it becomes really, really difficult to actually get shots onto the Combine because they tend to just kind of hang around right at the very peripheral of the grate. So you can just kind of see a couple of pixels of their head, and yet they're managing to shoot you down through it, which is a little bit frustrating the first time through. I think the best strategy there is just to take them out from a distance like I did. But yeah, the pickup crates, I think it might just be too much. Because, I mean, it's great that kind of around every single corner that you explore around, you'll probably find something useful in the form of a, you know, resupply crate. But yeah, I think the apathy kicks in quite quickly. It rapidly becomes less exciting to explore around. You kind of already know that you're going to find something, it's just a question of where is it. This Combine are on point with their grenades today, damn. So this is another area I had a little bit of trouble with my first time through the map. It's mainly because I didn't see the crate of rockets. So I got right up close to the concrete wall there, where the APC is, and I was trying to throw grenades up there because I didn't have any rockets. When that stopped working, I kind of got a little bit confused for a while until I actually saw the crate of rockets there. You notice it's not really picked out by anything. Perhaps there was a spotlight on it or some other kind of architectural element which kind of drew your attention to it. It's just kind of hidden in kind of shadow there. It's not really picked out at all as being important, which is why I missed it the first time. But yeah, this area is quite tough. I almost died here the first time through. Had quite a lot of trouble second time as well. It can be really tough if you don't take out the Combine enemies first, because you're trying to dodge rockets and machine gun fire from the APC, and then No, the Combine are throwing grenades at you as well to flush you out of cover. It can get nasty very quickly. So I suppose this is the only real non-combat section you find for the rest of the map. So as I was saying, that this section kind of annoyed me for another reason. I think there's just too many hopper mines. Just every 5 feet you have to pick one up and move it. Of course, moving my slight OCD, I have to remove every single hopper mine. But I like that as you come into this area, there's a hopper mine right in the way of your only way forward, so it's kind of a way to get the players to notice, like, oh look, there's a mine here, there might be more, I better be careful. It's a great way to kind of introduce the new threat. Nothing worse than just the player dying to something he didn't even know would be there. This might be nitpicking a little bit, but you've got the Combine Overseer voice in this level, kind of as an ambient sound. I think it just repeats way too often. She never shuts up! This is constantly in your face. It did kind of annoy me after a while. It's another great combat area. So again, you got this kind of, it reminds me a bit of Spherical Nightmares in a way, this section, because David Lundvall was a fan of just putting like a big main corridor with kind of little side areas around the sides to give choice to the player. Give alternate routes to attack and defend. This area reminds me a lot of Spherical Nightmares for that reason. Really nice setup. Perhaps a little bit more cover in these side areas would have been nice. There's a couple of props around the place, but I think a little bit more would have been quite nice. This is another interesting combat scenario. So you see the Combine up ahead, you've got a kind of choice. You can kind of assault them directly and run up to them. You can kind of retreat back to the area you've already been through. I'm guessing most players will retreat, because generally players don't kind of run forwards into unknown territory unless they're panicking. But I wonder if attacking directly up the ramp here would probably be a pretty valid combat tactic. Because you tend to get kind of ambushed from above back there in the defensible location. Once again, we've got that great vista. It's reused kind of 3 or 4 times throughout the map. It's great, great use of the layout to kind of keep showing players this goal. It reminds me a lot of like the way the Citadel is used in Half-Life 2, so you kind of see it right at the start and then you kind of keep seeing it over and over again, especially in the Follow Freeman chapter and all the other City 17 chapters. You're always getting closer and closer to the Citadel. So you just kind of assume that that's where you'll end up. I like the bottle smashing sound here, because it just makes you look up. And then you spot the more crates! I think Sam's got crate fetish. Might have to get help, you know. So here's an area which is notable. You see this big door here. And then you can look through the window and you see the control room. Unfortunately, on my first playthrough, I didn't even look in that area at all because there was nothing really interesting there to see. It just looked like a wall with nothing there. The door, while it is bright yellow, it's kind of in darkness, so it doesn't really stand out again. So I ended up doing this whole section, not actually realizing that door was important, or even hadn't really noted where it was in the map either. So when I get to that control room, press the button and see the door open, I had basically no idea where that was in the level. Didn't really compute that I had to backtrack to get back to it. There's some strangeness going on with the AI in this section as well. A couple of the zombies just kind of stand there until you get like point-blank range when they suddenly activate and come after you. It's a bit strange. Not quite sure what that was about. But I like the fact that the gameplay kind of changes up here. So you're fighting zombies, it's generally a little bit more close encounters. Seems to be a lot more emphasis on physics, like using the gravity gun a lot more here as well. Attention, unidentified person of interest. Confirm your civil So here's where you get your first real decent look at some of this new Combine architecture. I mean, it does kind of remind you of the Combine kind of walls, but it's just built in brushes instead, so it looks slightly different. I do like that. But again, I think just perhaps bolting on some Combine wall pieces, some wall braces and stuff like that, just to break up the silhouettes of all the brushes, probably would have looked really, really nice. So yeah, here's that door opening. I mean, a great way to fix this would probably, for me, would just be to perhaps slap a spotlight on the door. You know, like a really bright spotlight aiming directly at it so the player notices it. I mean, the colour will stand out, you just need to get some brightness on it. Here's another interesting combat area where the Combine try and outflank you around the sides. I like that. Again, it just gives a bit of choice to the players. They can stay out here in this large area, or they can go inside one of the tunnels and fight it out in there. Then on our way back, we get to fight a new type of enemy in an environment which we're already familiar with, which is quite nice, keeps things fresh. So we're fighting zombies on our way down here, and then we're going to fight Combine on the way back up. Definitely a fan of that. Yeah, some of these areas around here are quite under-detailed. I'd say this area is definitely one of them. It's very, very boxy, which is a real shame. And then this area is probably, it's probably my least favourite area of the map. I mean, this texturing here, these tile textures generally look really, really bad when they're kind of stacked up like this. It's generally just quite boxy. It just feels a bit uninspired, if I'm honest. The combat here is actually really fun. I love that you can kind of stay up here and blow stuff up with grenades. I actually really enjoyed the combat here. But just the visuals, yeah, really weren't doing anything for me. It's always fun watching NPCs fight it out in Half-Life 2. that's a great way to get the player to come down here, I guess. So kind of the information is there that the platform may be unsafe, or it's broken in one area, it's got cracks all over it. So if players do go for that ammo box straight away, they're going to be in trouble. If they use a gravity gun, they should be okay. I think it's just kind of fun that some players will jump over and try to grab the ammo box physically and fall down. Others may have used the gravity gun, they would have been fine. I think it's really interesting if you can put points of divergence in your map like that, where, you know, the map still plays the same, you have to go down there at some point to progress. But depending on how you play the game, how you get down there will be different. I think that's quite interesting. I think if you manage to find ways to do that, especially in Half-Life 2 where the levels are largely linear, providing as many points of divergence as possible is actually a really positive thing, I think. Because then you get those stories, like you can just imagine like in the Planet Philip comments or something on a level like this where someone will say, I did A and Z was the result, and someone said, oh, I did B and X was the result. It just creates some interesting discussion about the map. This gunship fight was quite tricky, actually. I had a lot of trouble with this the first time round because I didn't actually find any rockets until I came up here and found the rocket bin. The issue was that up here it doesn't look like there's barely any cover from the gunship. And there isn't really, there's enough, but it just doesn't look very safe, so I didn't go up there. And looking around the level, I didn't really spot any other rockets kind of just lying around. Well, they are there, but you know, I was so busy trying to dodge the gunship fire and dodging these combine enemies as well, I didn't really have time to look around properly. Yeah, I think it's another case of not directing the player enough to find these critical items that you need. I mean, there are. If we go down these stairs here, yeah, here we go. So there's rockets and supply crates down here. Of course, supply crates! Yes! So there's rockets down here, but they're just kind of hidden in darkness. They don't really stand out at all. So I didn't spot those. And the main rocket bin up in the control tower. I mean, I guess it's visible from way out where in the map, but I just didn't spot it. So it's probably my fault, really. I feel like, I don't know, I mean, after a big gunship fight, I feel like there should be some sort of respite from combat. I probably would have put some sort of puzzle area in this warehouse, like perhaps moving the shipping containers around to create a bridge or, you know, something like that, I don't know. But it just feels like there should have been some kind of downtime after the gunship fight. There's certainly not enough of it at the moment, I think. Kind of straight into combat again. Almost instantly afterwards. When we get to the end of this warehouse segment is where we start entering the combine structures. And there's a fantastic section at the end of this warehouse with some great lighting as you kind of open up the doors to the combine structure. There's just Sam does a great job with the combine lighting in this level. It's very much kind of, we don't care what it looks like, we just need to see. So it's just this giant spotlight placed on the door. I mean, I'm sure, obviously, Sam's placed it to look like this with a kind of an artistic vision of what he wants the spotlight to look like, obviously, but it just fits in with the Combine aesthetic so well. Like, the Combine don't care what it looks like, it's just a spotlight so you can see what you're doing. And it's just right there in your face, they don't care. It's really, really nice. I hope I'm explaining it well enough. But like, as a side effect, it does create this great kind of highlight in the environment. You get some great shadows cast from it. It just kind of dominates your view as you enter it. It's really, really nice. There's a couple of sections like this as well. It's almost like the Combine put lighting in as an afterthought, you know. There's a couple of sections where it would be pitch black, aside from just one giant spotlight that just creates these big cascading shadows across the whole environment. It looks fantastic. I mean, it would have liked a big lens flare on the actual light, but yeah, the actual spotlight effect looks great. Again, some AI weirdness. Not sure what causes that, really. It happened on a couple of the zombies in that area before. I never actually tried pushing these shipping containers around the gravity gun to kind of crush the Combine. I wonder if they're actually physics props or if they're just static. I never actually checked. That could have been quite fun. So this Combine architecture here again, it feels slightly under-detailed from what it should be. I feel like there's some opportunities missed here to create some really interesting stuff, like stuff on the ceiling with like the wires and cables and everything. There could have been stalker pods hung up everywhere. But the actual basic architecture I actually really like. It looks Combined, but it looks different from what we're used to, which I really enjoy. And this area in particular, I think this is the best looking area in the entire mod, even though it's fairly simple. And again, you've just got this giant spotlight kind of dominating the whole scene, creating these fantastic shadows all over the place. It just looks fantastic, I love it. And I love the fact that there's, you've got two gunships kind of ready for takeoff, I guess. There's some kind of maintenance bay or something, and one of them is missing. I really like that, kind of piecing together actions we've done earlier in the level with kind of visuals later in the level. So one of the gunships is missing, presumably because we blew it out of the sky. So yeah, again here, it was really, really interesting. Kind of, I like the big bulky architecture, but I just feel like it could have used some props on it again, just to break up silhouettes and stuff like that, because it just ends up looking really, really blocky. This area gave me a little bit of trouble the first time through as well. I think I died two or three times here. It's pretty tough going. Lots of these Combine force fields all over the place. I think it would have been nice if perhaps some of them opened up and you could go and explore around a little bit. Because there's so many of them just blocking off all these different paths. It would have been nice to see what was back there a bit. So that's the kind of goal room. You want to be getting to that teleporter, but you never really know that. It just looks like another part of the environment. It doesn't really look special in any way. I think some kind of visual effects and sounds could have really helped here. As it is now, it's just kind of there in the environment, it's not really picked out at all. Again, here, even in small rooms like this, you just got that one bright spotlight just dominating everything. It's really, really nice. It's one of the things I really love about combine visual design. It's just the lighting in there. Yeah, the first time through I wasn't even really sure if I was meant to come down here. It felt a bit kind of wrong. Again, I think it's this whole area just needs to be set up more as an end goal. I mean, the only reason I came down here in the end was because of this teleporter effect here. And that is the end. So yeah, I really enjoyed the combat in this mod. I just feel like it could have been paced out a bit better with some downtime between major combat sections. There are a couple of small sections like the Hopper Mine section and a couple of travel sections between combats, but I don't think it was really enough. I think there needed to be some core gameplay of, you know, like puzzles or something between the combat to really space out a bit. But the combat itself I actually really enjoyed. It was a lot tougher than standard Half-Life 2 maps are, which I actually enjoyed. It's quite a good challenge, without ever being really unfair. I really like the Combine architecture at the end. It could have been slightly more detailed, but I just enjoyed the new look of it. And of course the lighting, as I've drivelled on about profusely now, is fantastic. Alright, I'll see you next time.